Hello friends, welcome to BSC Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about the crop wise cultivation of entomology's pest. So let's see, today we are going to see about the pest of pulses. So the first crop we are going to see is Bengal gram. So I have already listed about the name and scientific name as well as the family and order present in Bengal gram, and which also have the same family of borers in red gram. So I have going to explain about them in a combined manner. So I have listed the major important pest also present in the red gram of pod borers present in them. So Bengal gram and red gram mostly used to have a same pest present in them. So we can able to see one by one in this video. So the first one I am going to explain is gram pod borer, and the scientific name is Helicobacter pomigera. So while seeing about the biology, exocet to be spherical in shape with a creamy white in color, and the larva, which is said to be greenish to brown in color, and they use it to have a lateral line marking on their body, and the pupa, which is said to be brown in color, which used to occur in soil, leaf and pod, and also even in the crop debris. And the adult, which is said to be light brownish yellow with a stout mouth, which is said to be a stout mouth. And while for the identification of this gram pod borer, the forewing present in this gram pod borer is said to be have V-shaped speck, and the hind wings are which is said to be smoky yellow with a broad margin. As I have already told you, Helicobacter is a body pest in different crops, so it used to have a different variety of crops. So the symptoms present by the gram pod borers, we can able to note it down in the plant or so the larva used to damage the leaves as well as buds, flowers and pods. So we can able to see a big circular holes present in the pods, buds and even in the flowers, so which used to be known as the clean feeder. And some other symptom of damages are, the first stage is the defoliation of leaves, and you can able to see the larva head around thrust inside the pods, and the rest of the body is said to be hanging out even in the pods as well as in the flowers, and the pods which is used to have a round holes present in them. And the next one we are going to see a plume moth. So plume moth used to show the symptom of the size of pods hole is said to be like a pinhead size, small holes are present in the pods, and the small spiny caterpillar as well as pupae is said to be seen inside the pods. So it is the major symptom we can able to see in plume moth. So while seeing about the biology, the eggs are said to be green oval as well as laid singly on the bud as well as in pod, and the egg period is around 3 to 5 days, and the larva, which is said to be green or brown, which is used to have a spindle shape and covered with the short spines, are present in the pods as well as flowers present in the plant, and the pupae, which is said to be the larvae, which is said to be found attached to the pod surface, and they used to have a period of pupal period of around 4 to 7 days, and the adults, which used to be a brown plume like wings present in the leaves. So these are the eggs as well as larva, and the pupal stage with the adult images I have shown in this. You can able to see with the damage about how they affect the crops. And the next one we are going to see is spotted pod borer, and the major symptom we can able to notify among these spotted pod borers are, they use it to bore holes on the buds as well as flowers or even in the pots, and they used to feed on the seeds present in these pots, as well as the entrance of the pod is said to be plugged out with the excreta. So there is no, we can able to see that the entry was said to be surrounded by the excreta, so we can able to classify them with the gram pod borers, so which is said to be a cleaner one. But in spotted pod borer, they used to cover the surface with their excreta, and the larva, which even bores into the tender stem of the plant as well. So I have classified them with their egg, larva, pupa and adult with their damage in this picture, so you can able to see it. And while seeing about the biology of the spotted pod borer, so the eggs are said to be laid in the cluster form of around 10 to 15 on the leaf as well as bud or even in the floss, and they used to have a period of around 5 to 7 days, and the larva, which is used to have a lined beard, body of conspicuous black spot. You can able to see that in the picture, which used to have a larval period of around 10 to 12 days, and the pupal period is around 7 to 9 days, and the pupa is to be an which can be happened in crop soil as well as crop debris, and the adult is to be a medium sized dark brown four wing moth, which used to have white cross band in the middle, and hind wings are said to be whitish with the brown broad. And the next you are going to see about the spiny pod border, where the scientific name is Etiella zincinella, and the symptom of damage where the dropping of plant and young pods, and the older pods which used to mark the brown spots with the larvae which used to be have been entered in them. And the spiny pod borders biology, you can able to see the egg used to be a white elliptical and laid in small groups on the developing pods with a egg period of around 5 days, and the larva which is said to be green but which is said to be young and turns into red color later onwards. They feed inside the pods, and the larval period is around 30 days, and the pupal period is around 9 days, and the pupa is said to be an uptake pupa, and the moth which is said to be adult. So, which used to have a grey forewing with the white costal margin on their forewings, and they used to have a purely and translucent hindwings, which is behind the forewings. And the next one we are going to see is field pond borer, and the symptom of damage which used to bores the larva bores inside the pod and feed on the seed within them. And the scientific name of field pod borer is Adisura atkinsoni. And while seeing about the eggs which are said to be laid in flower or pots, and they use it to be have a period of around 2 to 3 days, and the larva which is said to be green, which used to have a resemblance of Helicorpa omnigera, but which can be we can able to distinguish by lateral markings present in them at and also there is a humped lost abdominal segment present in the Adisura atkinsoni larva, and they used to have a larval period of around 14 to 16 days, and the pupation takes place in soil which is an uptake pupa with a period of around 8 to 12 days, and the adult which is said to be yellowish brown forewing and white hindwings. And the next one we are going to see is blue butterflies, and where they used to have a symptom of damages or the larva is a destructive stage, and the buds, flowers and young pods are used to have a bore holes present in them, and there is a presence of slug like caterpillar. So the blue butterfly's larva is a slug like caterpillar, and there is also a honeydew white secretion with the mount of black ants once the blue butterfly affects the plant. So while seeing about the scientific names of blue butterfly, the scientific name is Lampetus boeticus Cathochrophophus cynosus. So it is the scientific name of blue butterfly, and the egg used to be blue, plain blue, and laid on the buds which used to have a period of around 4 to 7 days, and the larva which is said to be 12 mm long with the green and rounded with the rough skin, and they are said to be oval, flat and slug like in structure, and they used to have a larval period of around 9 to 27 days, and the pupation which is said to be an uptake pupa, and pupation occurs in soil as well as in plant debris, and the pupation period for blue butterflies is around 8 to 10 days, and the adults which are said to be slender bluish gray with a span of 30 mm. So these are the pictures of egg, larva, pupa and adult of blue butterfly. So while seeing about the classification between Lampetus boeticus as well as Cathochrophophus cynosus, the adult which is said to be the moth with a grayish blue with a prominent black spot in the hind wing, and there is also a long tail. But while seeing about the adult of Cathochrophophus cynosus, the adult is said to be blue with a medium size with a 5 black spot on the hind wing and the 2 black spot in the inner marker region. So it's how we can be able to classify these two blue butterflies. And even in the Lampetus boeticus, the ventral side of the wing which used to have numerous stripes and bone spots present on them. And the other pest we are going to see are red gram pod borer. So the symptom is a pinhead size hole as well as in plume moth, and the seeds which used to be shriveled, stripped or partially eaten by the red gram pod borer. So the economic damage caused by the red gram pod borers are all the immature stages of egg larva pupa, which is to be occurred monthly inside the pods. So they use it to infest a single pod, and the larva entirely feeds on the seed present in them. So the entire portion of the embryo will not get germinated, and there is a trail of excreta renders inside the inedible pod of the plant. And the scientific name of red gram pod fly is Melanogryso obtusa. And the adult which is to be emerges out of the pupae inside the pods and escape the pod through the thin epidermal window. And the female which can able to mate at 1 day of age and oviposit thereafter. And the adult which used to have black at the naked eye, but the thorax and abdomen have a distinct and green metallic sheath. Once we can able to see under the magnification, and I have given the picture of the magnified red gram pod fly. And the other thing we are going to see is pod wasp, and the scientific name is Tanystigmoides cancheniae. And the adult is to be a small wasp of around 2 mm long, and they used to have a legless white larva which is said to be around 2 mm long, feeds on the young green seeds, and which is said to be found inside the pod walls. And they are also a translucent fat oval eggs, are which are said to be laid on the flowers and on the ink pods. So the major symptoms caused by these damn larvas as well as the pest are the malformed pods, and which they do not develop, and attack lodicule which remain undeveloped, resulting in the abnormal appearance of the pod. So we can able to identify this pest. So these are the pictures of the pod fly, so egg larva as well as the damage and pupa and adult. And the other pest is stem fly, where the scientific name is Ochiomyia pacioli, and it is said to be a maggot which is said to be yellow colored one, and the adult is said to be a tiny black fly, so which used to have the appearance of a house fly. And the symptoms which is said to be happened in the larva, which is a maggot stage, so the used to cause a seedling wilt, and dry used to have a dried leaf within the swollen stem present in them. And some other flower feeders which are said to be present in Bengal gram and red gram are the blister beetle flower webber, red gram eriophyte, and pulse beetles. So the flower feeder, where this while seeing about the flower feeder, first we are going to see about the blister beetles, where the scientific name is Mylabris pustulatus, or else we can able to call it as Haecilius pustulatus. And the eggs which are said to be light yellowish in color and cylindrical in shape, and the larva which is said to be a young grub which is said to be white in color. And the adults, where they used to have elytra with two transverse cross-grained colors with orange as well as black in the wings. And the management is manual collection and killing of the insects with insect net. And the killing of adults with kerosinized water is the only possible solution we can able to do in the natural way, or else we can able to go for insecticide sprayings like dichlorovas 500 ml per hectare, or else carbaryl 500 gram per hectare. And the symptom of damage, the adult is a voracious feeder of buds and flowers. And the next one we are going to see is flower webber, where the scientific name is Eublema hemirhoda. And the larva which is said to be a green with black head and long white hairs on the body. And the larva webs the flower head and bores into the pods. And the next one we are going to see, it's eriophyte mite, and the scientific name is Acaria cajani, so which used to be the transmitter of red gram sterile mosaic virus. So eriophyte mite is the vector of red gram sterile mosaic virus. And the identification of the pest is nymph and adult, which are said to be white in color, and they are very small, microscopic, as well as vermiform, like two pairs of anterior located legs are said to be present in these mites. And the management practices, we can able to go for eriophyte mite or spraying of Dicofol 2 ml per liter, or else vegetable sulfur of 2 gram per liter of water is the best management practices. And the next one is field cum storage insect pest, which is said to be found in red gram, is pulse beetle, and the scientific name is Calobrucus chinensis. And the adult is said to be a mottled brown beetle, and the eggs are said to be laid on the pods or else in the stored seeds. And the damage of the symptom, the round exit hole as well as the white eggs are on the pod wall or species, and infested and stored seed can be recognized by the eggs on the seed surface, and the round exit holes with the flap of seed core he said to be present in these pest and the management, we can able to go for the pulse beetle or drying the seeds with adequate required moisture level of up to 10%, and we can able to use pitfall traps in the storage grounds, and we can also go for seeds which is to be admixed with linden 1.3% D 1 kg, or else in pungam oil 1% monocrotophos 36 WSC 400 ml for every 100 g of seed is the best one, and also in pack lined in poly lined gunny bags can be used for storage for the storage of pulses we can able to make in brood chips. And now we are going to see about the pest of black gram, green gram, as well as in cowpea. And I have given the names, the scientific name, family and order. So these are the insect where which was differed from black gram and Bengal gram. So the pest present in these black gram, cowpea, or the bean aphids, leafhopper, pod bugs. So we can able to see one by one them. So these are the damage of aphids on green gram and some other images of them. And they used to be the vector of stunt disease in chickpea, as well as the honeydew secretion, which used to increases the movement of black ant movements due to the presence of aphids. And they also use the leaves, inflorescence, stalk, and egg plants are covered with dark colored aphids present in them. And the newly laid lymph is to be transplanted with reddish brown color, and after 30 minutes the dim start moving, and it used to hovers and starts feeding on the plant. And the adult, which is to be apiterous female, or to be shiny and dark brown or black in color. Allied forms are to be greenish black with transparent wings, which is to be a movable one from one plant to another if the colony is to be bigger. And the next one we are going to see is leafhopper, and the scientific name is Emposca kerri. So these are the pictures of leafhopper. So the symptoms are the leaf mottled and yellowish in color, and the green color insect which usually found under the leaves. And while seeing about the biology, the eggs which are said to be yellow, which is laid under the leaf, embedding them in the leaf veins, and the nymph, which is to be wedge shaped, very active, as well as suck the sap from the under surface of the leaf. And the adult, which is said to be 3 mm long and greenish yellow. And the pod bugs, so where the scientific name is Riptotorsus pedestris. So the symptom of damage on the pods are said to be with black spots and shedding on green pods, and they are said to be poorly filled pods with shriveled grain inside them, and the eggs are said to be laid in clusters as well as 3 to 15 mm round. And the nymph, which is said to be newly hatched nymphs, are reddish in color, and the later insta changes, they used to be converted from greenish brown. So some of the scientific name and based on the classification as I have given, and these are the pod bugs, images, eggs, larva, as well as the damage. So some other pictures, and the lab bug or sting bug, where the scientific name is Coptosoma cribaria, and it is the adult is to be small and subglobular, where they used to show the appearance of brown sting bug with a characteristic buggy odor present in them. And the symptom of damage where the cluster on the plant pods are and suck the sap, it has the characteristic buggy odor. And the white flies, it is the images of white fly. And the symptom of damage, which is a white fly, is a vector of yellow mosaic virus in the black gram, green gram, as well as in cowpea. And the leaves are mottled and which are said to be yellowish in color by the transfer of these viruses. And these are the white fly damages present in the green gram due to the transfer of yellow mosaic virus. And seeing about that egg, which has to be stalked and sub-electrical, which turns into brown color later once at the single which has to be present laid in this lower side of the leaf. And the nymph is said to be elliptical or in emergence. So they feed the mouth to the plant tissue and feed on the leaf sap. And the adult, which is said to be yellow body covered with a white waxy bloom. So for these management of sucking pest in all these pulses, or use of yellow sticky tap, as well as dusting of malathion at 25 kg per hectare, and spraying methyl demoate 25 EC at 500 ml or dimethyl 30 EC 500 ml per hectare is the best method. And the leaf feeders present in the pulses are the lab leaf miner, and the scientific name is Cyphos kita korlora and the scientific name is symptom of damage where they used to have a irregular papery mites on the dorsal surface of the leaves. And the identification of the pest, which are where the larva is said to be orange colored caterpillar, management is application of Malathion 25 kg per hectare. And the leaf folder, where the scientific name is Anticarcia irrorata, and the symptom of damage, where the leaf folds used to be together. And the identification of pest, the larva which is said to be green color, an adult which is yellowish brown moth with an oblique back line of the wing. And the leaf webber, Eucosma critica, and where the symptom of damage, the leaves rolled up apically and become white and dried up. And while seeing about the biological stage, egg is said to be oval as well as creamy white in color, which are said to be singly laid on the leaves as well as in petiole. Larva, which is said to be pale yellow color in a moderate stout, and they used to have smooth hibernates in larval form. And the pupa, which is to be pupated in a thin paper white silken cocoon, adult is to be dusky brown with four wings having four black spots as well as silvery transparent mark. And the management of leaf feeders are applying Malathion at 25 kg per hectare. And some other pest which was important in all the pulses are, so the first one is red gram leaf roller, and the scientific name is Calotilia soyella. And the scientific symptom of damage, where they are used to leave the fold together with the tender shoots and showing bore holes. And the identification of the pest, larva is said to be stout, long with the smooth yellow with brown headed ones. And the hawk moth, which is a sphinx caterpillar, which is said to be found in pulses, and they used to be appeared with a dead skeleton head on the thorax. And the symptom of damage, which is a voracious feeder which used to feed on the leaves and defoliate the whole plant. And the larva is to be stout greenish white oblique stripes, and a prominent dorsal curve and a horn on the eighth abdominal segment is their identification one. And adult, which is to be a brownish green hawk moth with a thorax, is the characteristic of skull marking, so which is an important one in the hawk or death hit moth. And the four wings are dark brown when the hind wings are yellowish with two black lines. And the sphinx moth, so about the biology, eggs are said to be bluish green, and larva, which is robust dark feeder with the used to have red patches on side and curves horn at the anal end. Pupa, which is said to be an uptight and jug like handled one. And the adult, which is said to be stout pale green color, which is used to cause the defoliation. So the major thing we can able to go for is the hand picking of the caterpillar, so which is to be sufficient in small area. And you can also use it to have a light traps which can able to monitor the population of the moths. And the management best for these insects are, so deep plowing, which is used to expose the pupa to the predators, and hand picking and collection, or else we can able to go for the dusting of phosphorylated Malathion 5% at 25 kg per hectare at the 30 days as well as 45 days after sowing. And the other thing is leaf cutter bee, where the scientific name is Megachile anthracnose, and the symptom is where they used to have a characteristic damage, so which used to give a neat circular or oval patch of leaf cut in the margin of the leaves. And the identification, adult are said to be hairy medium sized dark insect, and which used to have an abdominal tinge with a red brown color. So they used to collect these cuttered leaves to build up their seedings in the wood hedges as well as etc. And the management is, the insecticide is ineffective against the preventing leaf cutters, so cover up susceptible plants with cheesy cloths or else loose netting, like preventing leaf injuries. And the number of leaf cutter bees present in the area can reduce the breeding sites which are to be eliminated. So the application of sawdust of the tunnel thick stemmed plants with hollow openings. So I have given the lecture notes in the description. Please comment about the video and join us in the Instagram page. If you like the video, like it and share it with your friends, and subscribe to BSC Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch up in next videos.